The FastGene PAGE Protein System is a polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis set that is used for separation and analysis of proteins. During PAGE, proteins migrate through a gel matrix in response to an applied electric field. The FastGene PAGE Protein System contains all necessary PAGE components, including a complete electrophoresis set and a complete gel hand casting set. In this video, we will show you how to assemble the components for gel electrophoresis and run a polyacrylamide gel for protein analysis. Unpackage all components for gel electrophoresis from the boxes and plastic bags. This includes an inner chamber with long electrodes, an inner chamber with short electrodes, three kinds of sealing strips, a dummy cassette for two different gel sizes, a buffer chamber tank, a lid with power connectors, gel shovels. Start with selecting the inner electrophoresis chamber with long electrodes. Here is where the gels or dummy cassettes are fastened. In order to properly seal the inner chamber, the gel electrophoresis set contains three different kinds of U-shaped sealing strips. Select the short, wide sealing strips for using 10x8cm gels and FastGene precast gels. Select the short blue sealing strips for hand cast gels or the short dummy cassette if running only one gel. The long white sealing strips are used for 10x10cm gels, such as in vitro gene gels. Choose the matching U sealing strip for your gel and fix it in the groove of the electrophoresis chamber. Lean the dummy cassette and gel against the matching U sealing strip. These should rest on the white plastic pads below. The inner chamber has an innovative closing mechanism with two side clips. Press the two side clips simultaneously to the inside. This will tightly lock the gels in their inner chamber. Now select the gel chamber tank from the gel electrophoresis components. The tank has one electrode mark on each side for the positively charged anode in red, and a negatively charged cathode in black. Match the red and black marks of the inner electrophoresis chamber to the red and black marks of the tank. Insert and hang it on the side with the two plastic humps. If three or four gels are used, select the inner electrophoresis chamber with short electrodes and repeat the insertion of sealing strips and gels. Insert it with matching colors into the remaining spot in the tank. Remove the comb from the gel. Slowly pour the previously prepared running buffer into the inner electrophoresis chamber and fill it completely. Then pour the running buffer into the chamber tank. Fill the chamber tank up to the appropriate mark when using two or four gels. Load the samples into the sample wells. Make sure to inject the sample slowly and let it sink from the pipette tip down to the bottom of the well. Additionally, apply a protein marker to the gel in order to be able to estimate the size of the protein bands. Select the lid with the power connectors. Match the red and black electrodes of the lid to the red and black marks on the tank and connect the lid to the electrodes of the inner chamber. Make sure the plastic humps of the tank go through the two narrow openings of the lid. Plug the electrode connectors of the lid to a power supply and start the run. Typical power settings would be a constant voltage of 120 to 150 volts for 30 to 40 minutes. But this can vary depending on the gel type and buffer conditions. By applying the electric field, the protein samples start migrating through the gel. Smaller proteins travel faster and migrate further than larger proteins. Lift up the inner electrophoresis chamber and pour out the running buffer. Slide the side clip fasteners open and remove the gel cassettes. You can now remove the gel from the gel cassette and continue with the next application, such as Kumasi staining or Western blotting.